Next we have Miss 5 Feet of Fury, for SmackDown and Raw Women's Champion, the one and only Alexa Bliss! That was intense.
I go to jail for you!
You better stop your tracks there. And last but not least, the winner of the greatest Royal Rumble, the Monster. Ron, I see you got a special chair there.
And you're still as tall as Alexa!
What's your experience been so far with the photos and autographs and everything?
I mean, Megan, it's just been awesome seeing all the fans at WWE Universe come out and support us today and stuff. It's a dream and true, man. You guys make my life easy and make everything that I do mean something.
It has been a lot of fun. I love being WWE Universe. Everyone is so excited to be here. So, and it's really cool to see a couple people dressed up like me, which is really cool. Yes, like right over there. I see you. And it's been fun. And actually, I'm very surprised. This is the first time I've ever been eye level with Braun.
The first for all of us. Chin?
I'm good. I don't speak English, so.
Alright, I'll tell you what, we're gonna open up questions. We're gonna start over on this side right here.
Hey guys, so one day I really want to be a wrestler, and I know you guys worked your butts off in NXT, not only to get to Raw or SmackDown, but if you had like someone in front of you, what advice would you give them?
It's a good question. What advice? You're thinking like you're going to answer it, but I know you're not going to. Ron, Lexi, you got something, Chin?
Show me the answer.
Yes.
So I want to be a wrestler. I tried to learn the martial arts, like karate, judo, kung fu, everything. Yeah, so you should try some sport or some experience.
My advice. My advice would be, if it's something you're truly passionate about, do it. I mean, I told my mother I was trying out for WWE, and her response was, "The hell you are." And so I... Sorry. And so,
just picturing your little mom saying that.
I know, but she's shorter than me, so that's like the funny thing. But if it's something you truly care about, go for it. And it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. It's a day-by-day process. If it doesn't come to you quickly, it doesn't matter, because it's going to. And if you learn the process, love the process, and respect the process, it'll take you where you need to be.
Touching on what Alexa said, and it's setting goals. Like, you have a grand goal of wanting to be a WWE superstar, but they're setting goals on the way to getting there, of small things that you have to achieve on your way to achieving your greatest goal. It's setting out little things, whether you want to lose some weight, gain some weight, learn to be better talking, learn to be better acting, and this and that. And it's just, don't let anyone tell you the sky's the limit, because it's a lie, because there's footprints on the moon. You sir.
Yeah, all three of you guys, the Mix and Match challenge we had a few months ago, and obviously, like, all, everybody, the whole thing is you guys just had seems to be having so much fun. Like, it was like, was a little looser, like, you know, less control, like, how much fun was it, and how, like, how did it feel different from regular?
Yeah, a lot of that was adding a lot with layers to the Braun Strowman character of working with Alexa Bliss in the Mix and Match challenge, and WWE did a really great job of kind of letting us do our own thing, letting us react off each other, feed off each other's energy, and show through to the screen to the fans and stuff like that. So it was a process that was unbelievably fun to go out there and be a little bit different than what you normally see me on Raw as the terrifying monster who destroys everything, to show you guys that I do have a softer side. I am still kind of a human being. So it was a lot of fun. I hope so. Maybe do that one day again, and if we can't make that a staple on Monday Night Raw, and get some titles out of it, because King Wilbur's taking it all away.
Yeah. And it was really fun to see Braun actually take orders from someone half his size. That was a lot of fun. It was definitely probably one of the most fun things I've done with WWE, and obviously having an amazing partner made it so much easier. And it's funny because we got the name from the WWE Universe. We were on Twitter and someone just said Teeth Little Big, and Ron told me about it, and I was like, oh my gosh, that's hilarious, because everyone has like these like real names, like awesome names. Like there was Boss Club. What were you guys? Never mind, he was good.
It's not here right now.
Really cool, like, official names, and so we thought it would just be funny if we were Team Little Big and see if it caught on, and it did, and it was awesome, so thank you all for the name.
What was your experience?
Well, not even very entertaining. She was the unleashed cat.
She was a cat to your King of Shrunk style?
So she was King of Cat style.
Queen Cat Sound. They knew what you meant. Thank you very much, man. Over here.
Hey, how you doing? Well, I grew up in an age where when you watched the WWE, you didn't get to know who these characters were in real life. Because of media, we see that Braun's actually a really nice guy, and Alexa loves her pets, and you know, so we get to see a different side of you. So, yeah! Well, the WWE Universe is a big part of who these characters are. But here's the question: when somebody comes in like Ronda Rousey, gets a title shot after just one match, or Brock Lesnar doesn't defend his title every 90 days. I think it's crap. How do you guys feel about that?
Well, that's none of my business.
Exactly, it's above my pay grade.
Darn that Triple H.
Thank you very much. I like those. Those are good answers. What's your name, man? What's your question?
My name's Kenny, and I know we talked a lot about what it takes to get into the WWE and be in wrestling, but if you guys weren't in wrestling or any form of athletics, where do you guys think your career paths would take you? Like, what did you want to do outside of wrestling?
I wanted to be shorter. Surfer? Surely my shorter is about shouting.
Surfing! Surfing! You still get to do that, son!
So, I want to go every day.
You can still do that!
Once a week.
Eventually, we'll get there.
Also,
move to Florida!
Need to practice more. I never met sharks still.
No shark yet?
Just dolphins, seals, and animals.
They can see you here. Shin's in touch with the ocean. He's one with the sea. Lexi?
Well, I went to school for diet, and so my goal still is One day working with people with eating disorders and opening a halfway house for people who are not in full-time treatment but can't be, you know, living on their own with, you know, certain disorders. So I would like to do what my mother wanted me to do and use my education. And that's probably what I would be doing.
With me, I'd like to think I'd still be able to compete in strongman. I don't know if my body would have held up much longer than that, because that sport was even more demanding, I think, on the body than being a WWE superstar. I don't know. My whole life I've tried to not have a normal job, I guess, per se. I feel like I was given a few gifts that not everybody gets in life, so I've tried to use them to the fullest and to inspire people and be, per se, someone's hero, man. That's my biggest thing. Like, my biggest take back from being a WWE superstar is getting to work with the kids and being an influence on children's lives, because they're the future.
If not, go get these hands. What's your name? What's your question, man?
Hi, my name's Josh. Hey, Ron, now the school's out. Are you going to go back to the Tack House?
Yeah.
I was just FaceTiming the other day because they just dropped our merch and stuff like that, and I had to show it off to him, and yeah, I'm just trying to talk his mom and let him have a little free time. So I had to go after the broken one in the eater of worlds.
What's your name, man? What's your question?
My name is Kevin. If you could have a match with any former WWE superstar, who would it be? What would the stipulation be? And for Shinsuke, you could use a pillow fight.
Andre the Giant.
Yeah.
Oh. So called the he used to work a little bit skinnier when he was a monster Russian. So just like kind of dream, right? So I can imagine like that kind of huge.
What kind of match would you have with him? Just cage? No DQ?
I quit match.
What about you, Lexi?
Trish Stratus in a steel cage match.
Tweet that. Let's make that happen. Ron?
Even so, she already said Andre. Andre would be a huge one that I would love to have an opportunity to. But I think the immortal Hulk Hogan.
Yeah!
Let's make it your round.
Don't change it!
Thank you.
He's liable to come back.
Allergies. What's your name? What's your question, man?
My name is Alvin, and this is going to Strong. First off, congratulations on winning the 50-man battle Royal Rumble. How was, when you winning that Royal Rumble in Saudi Arabia, how do the fans react when you won that match?
Oh man, the whole Saudi Arabia experience was just unbelievable. WWE's making waves around the world. Like, we set standards around the world with this, with being one of the first events to ever allow women to come and watch the show. And we're moving forward around the world and helping to bring everyone up to date on just being modern and stuff. And the fans, the crowd was just, you could tell that they were so excited and happy. We were like, I'm getting goosebumps. Because there was 8,000 people there going crazy, having fun, taking their mind from their day-to-day grinds and expressing themselves, having fun through us. And it was just, man, it's a humbling experience just to be able to represent such a great company around the world and be a forefather in the sports entertainment world, you know?
What's your name? What's your question, man?
What's up, guys? My name is Wayne, and my question is this. Now, we know there's other wrestling companies like New Japan Pro Wrestling, Lucha Underground, Ring of Honor. My question is, who would you recommend to Vince McMahon or Triple H from all those other companies to bring into the WWE?
Kenny Omega!
Are you talking about like talent-wise in there?
Talent-wise, yeah. Oh, both men and female.
I feel like we got the only one. Jericho is the only one that goes back and forth. I think that's a Jericho across the board, 100%. Bring him back!
Yeah!
Bring him back. Bring a list. Bring your list. Where's your man? What do you got over here? What's your name, Star Wars?
You know what? I have that same issue.
Future
content
team.
Got it.
My name is Owen, and my question is, if any of you could change the future, what would you change it to?
Ooh, that's a good one.
You have a different finisher than you do now.
The only time I probably want to change mine is when I'm wrestling like Big Show because he's so damn heavy.
What would you change it to?
Probably a submission move, so I don't have to pick him up.
I would say a submission move, but I don't have a big enough body to really just...
Just take her on either ankles.
Yeah. Get him down
to my level.
That'd be great.
So hitting like a weak point. Hitting weak point. I ran when I was a kid from karate. Yeah, no need to kick like this. Just like this. So kind of like a, you use like a pump to lick from the under. Yeah. So fighting stance is a cat stance. Yeah. Cat standing stance. So in Japanese, I don't know what that
is.
Yeah, crane. So,
what's the difference between
crane
and cat?
Okay.
Show us.
We call nekoashi dachi. This is the cat stance. Then, like this.
Thank you.
Don't use it.
We'll steal it.
So, what's your family show?
You know, okay, what's your name and what's your question?
Where we are in our careers right now, we don't really have a whole lot of time to practice. Every once in a while we'll walk through some stuff, but we wrestle at least 4 days a week. Like, we just got back this past Sunday from a tour in Europe where we did 13 shows in 14 days, and then before that we were in Saudi Arabia for a week. The week before that we were in South Africa, and the week before that we had WrestleMania. So there's not a whole lot of time to practice. It's kind of just go.
That's why I always say I live on caffeine and concealer. No time for anything.
Same.
What's your name? What's your question?
My name is George. My question is, in company, is there anyone in particular you'd like to have the chance to work with? I know, Braun, I wouldn't mind seeing you with Dijak or Brennan from down in NXT.
Yeah, Brennan!
And maybe one day soon, Keith Lee.
You never know, anybody can get these hands.
Yeah!
It's like a 24/7 open challenge.
Want to come get them.
Yeah.
Honestly, all the buzz is about Ronda, so I guess I don't have to.
You can beat her.
What?
That's why I chose her.
I never faced like a Morale, like a Team Red, so under Roman.
What's your name? What's your question?
Hey, my name is Derek. I got a question for Braun. This is kind of a weird question. It depends how you take it.
Remember, there's stuff in between.
Since you've been here, have you been using the places I pooped at this place?
Not yet. I was at home before I came on.
Okay. And I have a second one, just a quick one. Do you still think Alexa Bliss is kind of cute?
Of
course she is.
Heck yeah!
Thank you.
What's your question?
My name's PJ. You guys do get to travel a lot. Like, so you just came back from that European tour, South Africa and stuff. What is one of your favorite places that you've been to, both for the crowds and for places that you get to explore on your very, very downtime?
So, everywhere. So,
everywhere,
of course. But the Japan's crowd, so quiet. Yeah. But they enjoy it. Yeah. Just quiet.
Also, when they're not quiet is when they're not enjoying it. When they're quiet, they're actually watching.
Yeah. So, they kind of, so, watch wrestling like. Also, most Japanese guys know how to take bumps. Because we Japanese have judo for PE. From junior high school.
Oh, wow.
So you're saying don't mess with anybody in the crowd?
Crowd-wise, I love whenever we go to the UK because they come up with these songs. And it's crazy because they're all in unison and they just get on the same page real quick, and then those chants and songs come over to the US. And it's just very crazy to me. I remember we were there for NXT and we heard the baby song, everyone knows. And then we heard the Jordan Gable chants, like Jordan Gable, that one. And just it's crazy to see how it just carries over, and it's awesome. And visiting wise, anywhere at Disney. So. Yeah, and then we went to Tokyo Disney, and next is Shanghai.
Shanghai.
Disney around the world.
Yes.
Fast passes.
As far as probably the craziest crowd that I've had to perform in front of was in Santiago, Chile, like a year or two ago. We did two shots back to back in the same building, and every person, when their music hit, you would have thought it was Stone Cold 99 coming out. It was unbelievable, the energy in that place. I mean, not that any arena's electric for us. I mean, it's just, that's what goes on at WWE. You guys are amazing. But as far as, like, I think it's because we don't go to that place very often. The places that we only go to once every 2, 3, 4, 5 years, then when we show up, they really, really appreciate it. But at the same time, it got a little scary because at one point, I remember there was probably 1,500 to 2,000 people around the hotel. They had to have the military come in and put up walls and stuff to keep the people out because it got a little bit too much. But yeah, any opportunity, man. We travel all over the world. The WWE Universe is just phenomenal. I can't put it in other words. What's your name? What's your question?
Hello, it's me, the young boy Nicholas.
You not remember me telling you that you had to finish school before we could do this again? Do I gotta call your mom? Because I'm not taking the heat for this.
So, my actual name is Bella, but I'm also 5 feet tall, so yeah, a 10-year-old stature. I am new to the world of wrestling because I'm a camera operator for a web series called Nobody's Watching Wrestling, where the nobodies are a group of two drag queens and a DJ who watch wrestling and review it. And so they'll talk about the matches, and they really watch and like pay attention, and it's they're fans of all you guys, but they also get very distracted on like the bodies and the outfits. Because if you think about it, like wrestling kind of is drag. There's a lot of like. So what has been your favorite outfits, either yourselves or other WWE wrestlers?
Harley!
Brains was pretty fun. I don't know, I wrestle on the live events and I don't wear my singlet. I just wear my merch shirt, and my favorite thing to do at the end is stand on the second turnbuckle and tear my shirt off like Hulk Hogan.
I noticed there's a lot of, nibbles involved.
Yeah, there's like four or five Twitter handles just for my nibbles.
Oh my!
I want to see your nibbles tweet. You get to it.
Harley!
No, obviously my favorite is the Chucky doll. I'm kidding, Harley Quinn.
Yeah!
Yep. That was a good one too.
I just need a red one.
Keep it simple.
Oh,
AJ.
That's natural.
Yeah, it's all natural. Yeah. He wakes up like that for real.
He leaves the windows down in his minivan.
What's your name? What's your question?
Hi, my name is Eric. First of all, I'm a huge fan of Yu Nakamura ever since from New Japan Pro Wrestling.
Oh, thank you.
What's up? You guys probably got this question before, if you could face anyone from the past, present, and future. But my question is to all of you, if you could wrestle anyone from the past, present, and future, and have a road to WrestleMania storyline, and main event at WrestleMania, who would it be, and why?
I mean, I'm going to stick with the Hogan then, I mean, because it's Hulk Hogan, and what other test is going to be? Being a man and beating the man.
Yeah!
Obviously, I would say Trish, and to see who's the actual ultimate diva. Someone from Diva of the Decade versus the new era goddess, who is the ultimate?
Yeah!
Would you keep the steel image, or?
Absolutely. Nice.
Too many options.
It's going to be hell of a fight.
You like, you don't like?
This is my girl.
Yeah, so we Japanese do a pure fight at the school trip. Yeah, I have experience.
I chose the wrong match. What's your name? What's your question?
My name is Paul. Do you guys play the WWE Championship puzzle game? You know what I'm talking about?
Online.
The WWE Champions puzzle game. It's like an app for a computer or like iPads.
You see these things, I can barely text.
Trust me, I know.
Have you guys played it? I've played it.
Yes. I've been hearing like on the website they might add the women division. I'm just wondering when they would add them in.
Yeah, from August.
It should have had it already.
From August.
From August?
Yeah. Women division, right?
Yes. I don't know. Maybe. Hopefully, it's not really like, but hopefully, though, if you heard it, hopefully, there's a lot of things going on.
I'm just being curious about. Thank you, guys.
No worries.
Thank you.
What's your name? What's your question?
Hi, my name is Chris. My question is directed towards Braun Strowman. Did they tell you before the 2016 draft that you were going to be separated from the Wyatt family? And also, if you hope to work a program with Bray Wyatt one day, whether it's for the tag team titles or singles competition?
If funny thing with WWE and Lee is they don't ever tell me anything until about 5 minutes before it happens. So that's the shock and awe value is always there. Yeah, I had no idea I was being drafted away from the Wyatt family. At first, it kind of upset me a little bit, but then at the same time, I'm happy that I got pulled away because we are where we are today. And I would love to one day lock horns with Bray Wyatt. I learned a lot from him. We're still close friends in real life. So, he's an unbelievable competitor, and I wouldn't mind getting out there and putting on a show for you guys.
Thank you, you're all fantastic. Dude, what's your name? What's your question?
My name is Giovanni, and who's the toughest person you've ever fought?
Oh, good one. Don't say shots.
He's thinking hard about this.
Yeah, AJ Styles. How many times have I hit?
He's still walking.
It's like a same age son. I didn't talk about it, like hit his face. So not all like a toughest guy in this business, but the AJ Styles is so one of the most toughest guy called so I knew him from joining WWE. I know him before I knew him. Sorry. I don't speak English. I knew him long time. So he getting like better and better. So that's amazing. So some like a wrestler, so like a prime time, then they'll be getting down, change the style. He didn't change the style. So still like the same like high fly and hard hitting and like strikes. That's amazing, I think.
Say Nia Jax because not because she took my title, but because it is very hard to have a competitive match with somebody that you have an emotional attachment to. It is the toughest thing you will ever do. Someone being your best friend and then becoming your former best friend and then knowing that you have this emotional attachment. It's not just about a title, it's a friendship on the line, and that has to be my toughest competitor yet. She's really strong, it's scary.
As far as toughest guy that I've had to face, already here's some flag, but I gotta go with Roman, man. Him and I had back and forth last year. I mean, no one's pushed me like he has. That ambulance match we had was 45 minutes of hell. I mean, we beat the crap out of each other. And he's one of the few guys that can go out there and take these hands, no pun intended, on me and keep coming back for more. He's resilient. He's a tough SOB. And I've always enjoyed going out there and going to battle with him.
What's your question?
Hi, I'm Joe. Thanks for being here. Alexi, who's your favorite Disney princess? Ron, who's your favorite movie monster? And Shin, what's your favorite Michael Jackson album?
Yeah. Sweden.
So we're gonna get technical here.
Elsa's a queen!
My favorite Disney person is Tinkerbell. My favorite Disney princess is Sleeping Beauty. And my favorite non-princess, because technically she married the Beast, he's not really herself. And I just love Disney. I really do, guys. Issue.
I gotta go with Leatherface. No one can.
My name is Johnny. Short and sweet. I've been trying to hear one of these all day in person. Ron, can you war with me one time? Thank you guys for coming out. One more time, give it up for Shane.